Good morning, students. So welcome back. This will be the last video of this chapter, that is chapter number 2, and this is one of the most important theorems in Boolean algebra or Boolean logic, that is De Morgan's theorem. Okay, now before we go on looking into this De Morgan's theorem and proving them, let us pay attention to some of the important laws in Boolean logic. Students, there are so many laws in Boolean logic, but for this proof of De Morgan's theorem, whatever laws are important, I have noted it down here. Let us have a look at each of these rules one by one. Properties of zero. When any variable A or any variable is added with zero, answer is A. When any variable is in AND with zero, answer is zero. You have to bluntly remember these rules so that you are able to solve numericals and also you are able to prove this Boolean, De Morgan's theorem. So, any variable plus zero is A, same variable, and any variable dot zero is zero. So that was properties of zero. Properties of one, very important. One plus any variable is one. Okay. 1 dot any variable is that same variable here in our case. 1 dot A is A, 1 plus A is 1. So you have to remember properties of 0 and 1. What did we discuss in properties of 0? 0 plus A equal to A, 0 dot A is also is equal to 0. Similarly, properties of 1, 1 plus A is not equal to A, 1 plus A is equal to 1. And 1 dot A is equal to A. Very important property. A plus A. It is not 2A. This is not mathematics. So A plus A is not 2A. A plus A is A. Similarly, A dot A. It is not A square as per mathematics. A dot A is A. And these laws are called what? Idempotence law. So I again repeat. Idempotence law. A plus A is A. And A dot A is A. Finally, very important law. Complementarity law. Same variable with its not. A plus A bar, it is equal to 1. Why it is equal to 1? Both are reverse of each other. A dot A bar is equal to 0. So these are very important rules that we can use in this De Morgan's theorem proof. I will repeat once more. Properties of 0. 0 plus A is A. Correct? 0 dot A is 0. Properties of 1. 1 plus A is, what is 1 plus A? 1 plus A is 1 and 1 dot A is A. Then comes idempotence laws. A plus A is A, A dot A is A. And finally, we discussed complementarity laws. What does it mean? A plus A bar is equal to 1. A dot A bar is equal to 0. Okay? Fine. Now let us pay attention to De Morgan's theorem. De Morgan's theorem, I think you have heard this word once earlier in mathematics. If not, it will be definitely there in 11th standard mathematics. This is a totally different approach. De Morgan's theorem, listen to me carefully. De Morgan's theorem is one of the very important theorems in Boolean logic. And whenever actual real world circuit designing is there, De Morgan's theorem is very important in that case. Okay. Now, listen to me carefully. There are two De Morgan's theorems. Okay. We will discuss both of them, but we will prove any one of them in detail in this video section. Both of the proofs are almost 95% the same. So we will prove the first one. Okay. Because proof is little lengthy. And whenever we meet in class after lockdown, we will also prove the second one because there is not much of a difference between both of them. So first of all, let us see what does the De Morgan's theorem state. First rule of De Morgan's theorem. A plus B whole bar, okay, equal to A bar dot B bar. A dot B whole bar equal to A bar plus B bar. Now, first of all, this can be written in one more way. Second way is A plus B whole dash equal to A dash dot B dash. In the same way, A dot B whole dash equal to A dash plus B dash. Now let us have a quick look what is actually happening. Let us take this theorem. A plus B whole bar. Students, you know what is the meaning of bar? Meaning of bar is not. Okay. So how the answer is coming? Just see. A of bar. What is the answer? A bar means reverse of A is what? A bar. Plus of bar. What is the reverse of plus? Dot. B of bar. What is the B, reverse of B? B bar. Okay. So this is how this answer is coming. In the same way, A of bar, what is the reverse of A? A bar. Dot of bar, what is the reverse of dot? Plus. B of bar, what is the reverse of B? B bar. So this is how the rules are actually coming out. Okay? So I hope you are clear. You can pause the video now. See all the properties once, because this will be very useful in the proof. We saw both theorems of De Morgan's. We actually explained how the things are working. Now we will have detailed proof of the first De Morgan's theorem. And remember students, detailed proof will include three things. Number one, numerical proof. Number two, proof using truth table. And number three, proof using circuit diagram. So whenever this De Morgan's theorem, see, both the De Morgan's theorem will never be asked for proving in exams or in tests. Whenever a single theorem of De Morgan's come for proof, it will be at least of 4 or 5 marks. Such big is the proof, okay? So you can pause the video now, see both the De Morgan's theorem, see all the properties. Now we will be proving first De Morgan's theorem. Okay students, so let us start the proof of the first De Morgan's theorem, that is A plus B whole bar equal to A bar dot B bar. What we discussed, proof will be in three parts: numerical proof, proof using truth table, proof using circuit diagram. And the lengthiest of them is the numerical proof. So we will start with the numerical proof. And you will have a question in your mind, sir, can we only prove using a truth table? Can we only prove using circuit diagram? No, all the three proofs are always in combination, that is numeric, circuit and truth table. So first of all, let us start with the numerical proof. Okay, now we have to prove A plus B whole bar equal to A bar plus B bar. So we will start with certain suppositions. So we will say that let P equal to A plus B, because we are dealing with two variables A and B, and we are starting with A plus B whole bar here. So let us suppose P equal to A plus B. Now using complementarity law, please have a look there. What is complementarity law? A plus A bar equal to 1, A dot A bar equal to 0. So we will apply this complementarity law on P. So if we are applying, what we are getting? P plus P bar equal to 1 and P dot P bar equal to 0. Correct? Now, what is the value of P we took? Value of P we took as A plus B. So what we will do in both the equations now, we will put the value of P as A plus B. Let us put it. A plus B plus A plus B. I think instead of this dash, we will keep the bar. So throughout the equation, it will be easier for us both to understand. So A plus B whole bar equal to 1. Please understand how it is coming. P equal to A plus B, P bar. What is P? A plus B. So P bar will be A plus B whole bar. This is, it should be equal to 1. This we have to prove. In the same way, A plus B, sorry, dot A plus B whole bar should be equal to 0. So this becomes our equation number 1 that we have to prove. What we have to prove? We have to take LHS and we have to prove RHS to be 1. This will be our equation number 2. What we have to prove? We have to prove LHS should be equal to RHS, that is 0. Okay students, so as you have seen, I have written both the equations that we derived here. 1 and 2 both are written. This is our LHS, this is our RHS. So let us start. LHS, I think this is the LHS part, so we will be dealing with that only. Let us write it once to have systematic thing. A plus B plus A plus B whole bar. Okay. Now, students, please look above. Above means here. What is A plus B whole bar? That is equal to A bar dot B bar. I hope you are understanding. What is A plus B whole bar? That is equal to A bar dot B bar. So we will replace the value that A plus B plus, what is A plus B whole bar? A plus B whole bar is A bar dot B bar. Correct? Now pay attention what I am going to do now. Okay. Now we will scatter them in this way. This with this, correct? This with this. Okay. Now let us see how we are going to do. A plus B, correct? Plus A bar. This with this. What is the sign in between? Dot. Dot A plus B plus B bar. We will see it once more. The main confusion starts here. Okay. What we have done, we have written this, we have taken the De Morgan's and we have written in this form. Now what we are doing, we will create two pairs. One pair is this, okay, as you can see. A plus B plus A bar, that is one pair. What is the sign between A bar and B bar? Dot. So we have put down dot here, correct? What is the second pair? A plus B plus A bar is already taken. So what is left? B bar. Okay, this is just like algebra in maths, factorization in maths. We are regrouping and forming the pairs. I again repeat what we are doing. We are forming two pairs. A plus B plus A bar. What is the next sign? Dot. Dot is put here. Second pair is what? A plus B plus B bar, because A bar is already taken. Okay, so you can see this. This is the important step in the numerical proof. Now, certain rearrangement. A plus A bar plus B dot A plus B bar, sorry, B plus B bar. See the rule see the rule complementarity law. What is A plus A bar? 1. What is A dot A bar? 0. So here we have A plus A bar. What is A plus A bar? 1 plus B dot. What is B plus B bar? 1. A plus 1. Correct? Again look at properties of 1. 1 plus any variable is 1. 1 plus B is 1. A plus 1 is 1. 1 plus any variable is 1. What is 1 dot 1? 1 dot 1 is always 1. Okay, so our first proof, that is LHS, is equal to RHS. So first numerical part is over. Okay, pause this video, see this section, rewind this section again and again to have a better understanding. Okay students, so let us start the proof of the second numerical part of this De Morgan's theorem. We will write LHS the same, A plus B dot A plus B whole bar. Just as we did in the first case, what is A plus B whole bar? A plus B whole bar is A dot bar, A dot A bar dot B bar. So A plus B, what is A plus B whole bar? A bar dot B bar. Correct? Now let us see how the pairing we are doing in this case. In both the numerical, only the pairing is important. Pairing is correct, then answer will be easily correct. How we will pair? A with this. What is the sign in between? Plus. B with this. Okay. In the first case, what did we do? A plus B with this. Dot, this dot came in between. A plus B with this. Here the pairing is little different. A with this. Gradually, what is the, you can say, meaning of this pairing? We have to take out meaningful pairs. Meaningful means so that this, any of the rules will be applied. So here what we will do? A with this, plus sign will come in between. B with this. Okay, so let us write A with this. Okay, so with this means between, what is there? Dot. Dot A bar dot B bar. Correct? What is the sign in between? Plus. B between, no sign is there. So which sign is there here? Dot. Dot A bar dot B bar. See this once more. A with this. So A is written here. Between which sign is there? Dot. A bar dot B bar. Plus sign came in between. B with this. Between which sign is there? Dot. So A bar dot B bar. Certain rearrangement, A dot A bar plus B bar plus B dot B bar dot A bar. See second law of complementarity, A dot A bar, any variable with its not is always 0. So A dot A bar will be 0 dot B bar plus B dot B bar will be 0 dot A bar. Properties of 0, second rule. 0 dot any variable is always 0. So 0 dot B bar is 0 plus 0 dot a bar is 0, 0 plus 0 will be 0. So I think students, this we are arriving at our RHS. So students, this was the numerical part of the proof of De Morgan's theorem. You see this once more because this is very important and it is easy once you understand the patterns. Now we will go for what kind of proof? Proof using the truth table. Okay students, let us start the truth table. I have not drawn the truth table in advance so that you are able to understand which values and which values to take. So let us see, how many basic variables are there in this proof? Two. So let us say A and B. Now what do we want in truth table? Remember we did one kind of verification question in truth table in the earlier videos. We have to verify this part and this part. So let us focus on this part. First of all, what is required? A plus B. Correct? Sorry. A plus B. Now once A plus B is obtained, what we will do? We will do the whole bar of A plus B. Okay? So what is required? A, B. Then we took A plus B and then we took A plus B whole bar. Then we require what? Then we require this part. So first of all, we require A bar. Then we require B bar. And once both are obtained, we will take A bar dot B bar. See what elements are required. A, B. First we took A plus B, then we took A plus B whole bar. So this part is over. Then we took A bar, then we took B bar, then we took A bar dot B bar. So both parts are, these are the both parts in contact. How many variables are there? Two. Do not forget the rule. 2 to the power n. How many variables are there? Two. So how many entries will be there? Four. Remember the entry system, students? I think this will be clear to you by now. 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay, so let us proceed ahead. You know the rules of plus. 0 and 0 will be 0, 0 and 1 will be 1, 0 and 1 and 0 will be 1, 1 and 1 will be 1. A plus B whole bar, reverse of this, will be 1, 0, 0, 0. So this first part is ready. Now let us see A bar, reverse of A, 0, 0, 1, 1 will be 1, 1, 0, 0. B bar, reverse of B, 0, 1, 0, 1 will be 1, 0, 1, 0. So we are ready. 1 and 1 will be 1. Remember the rules of this dot and end. 1 and 0 will be 0, 0 and 1 will be 0, 0 and 0 will be 0. And as you can see, students, the parts in contention, A plus B whole bar, that is this one, and A bar dot B bar, that is the second one, both are the same. So this is proof of De Morgan's theorem using truth tables. Okay, so now finally we will prove De Morgan's theorem using circuit diagram, that is actually easier. Okay, please see it, note it down if you want. Okay students, so now let us see the circuit diagram part. Circuit diagram part is actually very easy because we know the basics of circuit. If you don't know, you can see my previous video. So first we will draw circuit for this A plus B whole bar. Very simple. First we will do A plus B. This is A. This is B. This is OR gate. What comes out of OR gate? A plus B. Now we want to put whole bar. Whole bar means we will do what? We will put a NOT gate. So this will become our A plus B whole bar. As simple as that. So this is circuit of the first part. Okay. Now let us do circuit of the second part. A bar dot B bar. So A bar means we will put a AND gate. We will take A. We will invert it using NOT. So this will become A bar. We will take B. We will invert it using NOT. This will become B bar. And finally putting it into the AND gate, we will get A bar dot B bar. Okay. So this was the circuit diagram proof of De Morgan's theorem. So by this we come to the end of proof of first De Morgan's theorem. How many proofs did we have? Numerical proof, which is the largest and somewhat the most difficult. You can see it again and again. Truth table proof, it is easy if you have understand the logic of truth tables, very easy. And finally circuit diagram proof. Each of this proof, we remember there were two De Morgan's theorem. We proved the first part. Second part we will prove once we meet later on in class, because both the proofs are actually the same. Each of these proofs regarding the De Morgan's theorem with numerical, circuit and truth table will be at least of 4 or 5 marks. So by this we come to the end of chapter number 2. that is data representation and Boolean logic, a very important chapter, and you can go through all the videos. Next time we meet, we will start with Python, that is our main component of 11th standard. This was two of the theory chapters, that is chapter 1 and chapter 2, were two of the theory chapters in this 11th standard computer science. That will be all from me. Thank you and have a nice day.